from the film and video archives of the National Hot Rod Association, spanning over five decades of the world's fastest motorsports. Welcome to the NHRA's Greatest Races, presented by ProCare RX. Now, here's your host, Bill Stevens.
Longtime drag racing fans will surely remember Ontario Motor Speedway in Rancho Cucamonga, California, the site of the NHRA World Finals between 1974 and 1980. The 1976 event was a stupendous gathering of eagles with superstars like Muldowney, Prudhomme, and Glidden all in their respective fields, and drag racing greats like Jerry Ruth, Richard Tharp, John Wiebe, and Wally Booth all playing supporting roles in the season's concluding event. World championships were at stake. Great drama could be found in every pro category. And right now, we go back to Ontario Motor Speedway with legendary NHRA announcer Dave McClelland and his partner Frank Farino for the 1976 NHRA World Finals, one of the NHRA's greatest races.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dave McClelland with Frank Farino at Speedway for the 1976 NHRA World Finals. This is actually two events in one, the World Finals conducted here today, plus the conclusion of the 1976 World Championship Series, a 43-race series throughout the United States and Canada. I guess, Frank, you've been in the pits, and on the World Championship level, Pro Stock's where the excitement is.
Yeah, because it's not yet decided. Larry Lombardo was very, very close to it, but then again, so was Warren Johnson. They meet in the first round, could be decided right there.
That's not the story in Funny Car, though.
Not at all. Dom Prudhomme has come here with the championship. I believe he only lost one event, the U.S. Nationals. He says the pressure's not on him, but you know the snake.
I know the snake, and the snake wants that $18,000 that's up for winner of Funny Car here at the World Finals. In Top Fuel, Frank Bradley has a mathematical chance of catching Richard Tharp, the points leader, but the story really centers around Shirley Muldowney of Mount Clemens, Michigan, who is the low qualifier, and in qualifying Saturday, recorded the second fastest speed ever in the history of drag racing. Shirley, winner of the 1976 Spring Nationals event, out to prove that she is definitely a winner, and here 5.77 seconds, her speed 249.30 miles an hour.
But that's not good enough for Shirley. She says she's going to break the 250-mile-an-hour barrier, and she feels she can do it.
Well, this is the place to do it. This is the world's fastest drag strip, Ontario Motor Speedway, and the best cars in the country throughout the world are here for this World Finals. We'll see some great action in all the categories. We'll start things off today with Top Fuel Eliminator, and this is one of the very important races, as this man, Frank Bradley, has a chance to win Top Fuel Eliminator World Championship title, a mathematical possibility. He's got to win all the races, the entire event, plus set records, both ET and mile an hour. His competitor is Pat Dakin, driving this race for Mike Kuhl. Kuhl from Torrance, California. Dakin himself hailing from Dayton, Ohio. Both cars staged. Taking a look at the drivers as they concentrate on the start. Side by side, it's Dakin through the finish line first by a half a car length, putting Frank Bradley out of competition. And that means it is Richard Tharp, the driver for the Candies and Hughes Top Fuel Dragster, your Top Fuel World Champion for 1976. Dakin holding on wire to wire for the victory. And here the man that has won the $25,000 season-end bonus money as the 1976 World Champion in Top Fuel Eliminator, Candies and Hughes Dragster, Richard Tharp, the driver from Dallas, Texas. His competition, James Warren from Bakersfield, California, the Ridge Route Terriers. You know, no matter how much pressure there is, James Warren always seems to remain very calm. Told Frank the one reason for this, his crew chief, Roger Coburn.
You know, he don't make no bonsai run. It's not safe, he don't run, so I don't have much to worry about. All I got to do is worry about leaving the line, and he takes care of the rest of it.
And leave the line he did. James Warren building a lead over Richard Tharp. And the supercharger exploding off of Richard Tharp's car. You see it bouncing down the track behind James Warren's dragster. The supercharger rolling into view now, coming to a rest. And Richard Tharp coasting off the track. James Warren taking the win. Let's watch and see if we can see where it comes off. It looks like just before the finish line. Warren with a big lead. And into the traps, and there goes the supercharger right at the finish line. Richard Tharp losing this race, but winning the world championship.
One other first-round matchup of note featured gentleman Hank Johnson racing a legendary Top Fuel driver rarely seen on television, John Wiebe.
Here's John Wiebe from Newton, Kansas. His competition, Hank Johnson from Marysville, Washington. Coming from all over the country and Canada for this World Finals event, John Wiebe is on the near lane, Hank Johnson in the far lane. it looks like Hank Johnson pulling a bit of a lead, and a big lead it is, as the finish line camera records Hank Johnson, 6.02 seconds, 236 miles an hour, his speed at the finish line. The 1976 Pro Stock World Championship boiled down to one race in the first round of racing here at Ontario Motor Speedway in the World Finals. It pitted Larry Lombardo and Bill Jenkins' car against Warren Johnson. They had raced the whole year long, separated by just a few hundred points as they came into this race, but a driving job by Larry Lombardo in round number one won the race for him over Warren Johnson. We see here it was only a matter of inches at the finish line as Larry Lombardo defeated Warren Johnson, winning the Pro Stock World Championship. Frank's down in the pits with Larry right now.
Well, Larry, you've locked it in, but the meet's not over, and now, kind of anticlimactic, you've got to go out and still run.
Yeah, I got three more rounds to go. We're not looking real good as far as power, but we're working on it right now. I found out a few things when I run, which I think a little bit faster, a little bit quicker. It might be enough to win the race, but I came to win the World Championship, and I won that. And that's the biggest thrill of my life.
Coming up, the decisive semifinals at the 1976 World Finals will determine who will be facing each other in all three professional categories for the event title on the NHRA's Greatest Races, presented by ProCare RX.
Welcome back to the NHRA's Greatest Races, presented by ProCare RX.
It's the Top Fuel semifinal at the 1976 World Finals. Low qualifier Shirley Muldowney is about to face father of Top Fuel star David Baca, Dennis Baca.
Shirley Muldowney from Mount Clemens, Michigan, has low ET, has top speed of the meet, done a tremendous driving job every run in eliminations thus far in the fives. Her competition, the best showing he's made in many a year, Dennis Baca from Concord, California. And Dennis Baca, a lot of oil and a fire for Dennis Baca. But it goes out quickly as Shirley Muldowney crosses the finish line first to put her in the finals of the World Finals.
The next pair included two all-time greats, James Warren and Jerry Root. Dave McClellan and Frank Farino set up this matchup.
Mechanical problems beginning to take their toll here at the World Finals. This semifinal round of Top Fuel between James Warren and Jerry Root. Frank, you've been on the starting line. What's going on down there?
Well, two problems. James Warren couldn't get his car fired because of a broken cam drive. Jerry Root has magneto problems. I talked to Steve Gibbs, the competition director. He wants to give both cars as much time as is reasonably possible to fire so they could have a race. Shirley Muldowney, on the other hand, talked to Gibbs, and she felt that if neither car could get fired, then she should be declared the winner. She then listened to Gibbs. Gibbs indicated he would give them as much chance as he could, and she would abide by the NHRA decision.
And it seems to have paid off because both cars are getting started, and it looks like we will have a race in the semifinal round of Top Fuel Eliminator between James Warren and Jerry Ruth. All right, Frank, here's Jerry Ruth from Seattle, Washington. In the far lane, the Ridge Route Terrors from Bakersfield, James Warren, the Rain for Rent special. The winner of this race to face Shirley Muldowney in the finals. A great run for Jerry Ruth, 593, 241.
Prior to the Funny Car semifinal in round two, Rick Johnson and the Beartown Shaker had an unpleasant surprise while facing the great Pat Foster.
Here are the Shady Glen car, Pat Foster the driver. Somewhat of a surprise, a relatively new car based in Southern California, staying around the Southern California racing scene. His competition, Rick Johnson, driving for Bill Shifsky. Beartown Shaker, they call it. It's in the far lane as you look at the starting line at Ontario Motor Speedway. Shady Glen and Pat Foster with a bit of a lead and wins the race. And in an engine explosion for Rick Johnson, the fire coming out of the car. And there goes the body off the car. The parachute's still out. Rick Johnson driving the car out into the grass. And he brings it to a stop. It's still upright. The rear tire's blown. The front tire's blown. And Rick Johnson is climbing out of the car. You saw it catch on fire. Rick Johnson apparently looks to be A-OK.
What goes through your mind the very second you realize that something like that is going wrong? I mean, was there at any moment when you panicked?
Not really. I mean, I've been through a fire before, and you just do what you think's right. Like, I hit the fire bottles as soon as I saw the flash of fire and saw the body coming off. I tried to keep the car on my side of the track and tried to stop it. The fire got so hot so quick it burnt the brake lines off the car, and I didn't have any brakes. There wasn't anybody in my way down there, so I just took it out in the grass and tried to stop it the best I could.
What happens now with this car?
Well, the body was completely destroyed. It cost about $3,000 to put a body on it. The engine was completely destroyed, and that's $11,000 down the drain. We were going to build a brand new car next month. Kind of looks now like we'll put another body on this car and try and get another motor together for Pomona.
Rick, I want to wish you the best of luck.
Thank you. Need it.
The first pair in the Funny Car semifinal featured Bob Pickett driving for Mickey Thompson against the already crowned world champion Don the Snake Perdomo.
Favorite Don the Snake Perdomo, the U.S. Army Monza. Smoke off Bob Pickett's car, the tires losing traction, and it's Perdomo through the finish line first. Once again, winning another race and moving into the final.
In the other semifinal pair, Ed the Eggs McCulloch won his matchup with Pat Foster in a most unusual and explosive way.
Ed the Ace McCulloch from Fresno, California. His competition, the Shady Glen car, driven by Pat Foster. A new car in competition on the West Coast, doing very well. Both cars completed their burnouts, now staging. Let's watch. A tremendous blower explosion for Ed McCulloch. And Pat Foster crossing the center line, that will disqualify him. But let's look at Ed McCulloch. He apparently is okay, but the car severely damaged. A tremendous supercharger explosion. As the tree went green, Ed McCulloch hits the gas pedal, and off comes the supercharger. There in slow motion, you see it once again. Foster leaving the line okay, but then crossing a little bit later. Let's watch again in super slow motion. Incredible deformation of the fiberglass body as that heavy supercharger comes up through the windshield, fuel spurting out of the lines, the emergency crew right on the scene. Ed McCulloch winning, but he's going to have a lot of work to do if he can even get the car repaired in time for the finals.
The first pair in the Pro Stock semifinal featured Larry Lombardo driving for Bill Grumpy Jenkins, who had already clinched the 1976 World Championship against the always dangerous Wally Booth.
Let's watch. A great leave by Wally Booth, and it's paying off at the finish line. A big car length victory for Wally Booth, 8.81 seconds to an 8.87, 6 hundredths of a second slower for Larry Lombardo. Here's the other American Motors Hornet, Dave Canners. His competition, Bob Glidden, the defending world champ. Canners with a wheels up start, pulls a slight lead at mid-track over Bob Glidden. Holds on for about a car length victory. Elapsed time, 8.77 seconds. So it'll be Dave Canners and Wally Booth in the final of Pro Stock.
Coming up, the final rounds in all three professional classes, plus the Sportsman Finals from the 1976 World Finals on the NHRA's Greatest Races, presented by ProCare RX.
Welcome back to the NHRA's Greatest Races, presented by ProCare RX.
It's time now for final eliminations in the three professional categories here at the 1976 World Finals. In top fuel eliminator, Shirley Muldowney. You've seen her run 249.30 miles an hour. All of her runs in the five-second category, speeds over 245 miles an hour, matched against Jerry Ruth. He ran a fine five-second time in that semifinal round against James Warren. In funny car eliminator, Ed McCulloch has been thrashing hard to get his car back together after exploding the supercharger in the semifinals. He'll be matched against Don Prudhomme, the defending champion. And in pro stock, it's an all-American Motors final as Wally Booth, the national champ, goes against Dave Canners. And here is the final, Dave Canners in the Hornet X against the AMC special of Wally Booth. Booth from Berkeley, Michigan. Wally Booth in the near lane takes it by just about a fender length. Tremendous race. In fact, a quicker elapsed time turned by Dave Canners, but the reaction times of Wally Booth gives him the win at 8.78 seconds at over 154 miles an hour. Wally Booth coming into the finish line right now, just about a half a car length ahead of Dave Canners. Here's Frank at the finish.
We were too far down the end of the line. How did it do coming off the line?
Very, very good. It was an extremely close race. My team partner was the runner-up, and I knew it was going to be close because I think he might have won a couple hundreds quicker than me, but I got there first.
Wally Booth, the winner of the World Finals Pro Stock category 1976 here at Ontario. Dave, back to you.
And here it is, Funny Car Eliminator Finals. Don the Snake Prudhomme, the defending champion. Ed McCulloch's been having a lot of problems getting this car running. Prudhomme has been running for quite some time. McCulloch, unable to do a full burnout, is trying to get the tires hot right now. The starting line crew trying to get him to the starting line as Prudhomme has been running for quite some time. You see the official starter, Buster Couch, motioning Ed the Ace McCulloch to the starting line. Buster telling McCulloch into the line right now. And apparently too much time elapsing. The tree goes green for Don the Snake Prudhomme. He wins the world finals for the second year in a row. Prudhomme, your funny car champion at 6.09. Frank's down with Don right now.
Congratulations again.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You ended the season the way you began the season. You beat McCulloch at Pomona for the Winter Nationals, and you did it again here. How did it happen off the line? There seemed to be some kind of a problem in getting going.
Yeah, apparently McCulloch had some troubles. You know, he was plagued all day, and it was just unfortunate that we couldn't make a race out of it. But they told us to fire. I fired, went to the starting line, and McCulloch was apparently having problems. And you can't run too long because there's no water in these engines, you know. So, therefore, they only have a certain length of time, so he got a red light, and I went on.
You told me you were going to take a little bit of a vacation. This is not a bad way to get it going, is it?
Yeah, looks like we have a few bucks to do it with. It's kind of nice.
Don, we'll see you next season, and congratulations on a sensational season.
Thank you, and I'd like to thank the Army, too. They really supported us.
Don Prudhomme, the winner of the 1976 World Finals Funny Car category. Dave, back to you.
Frank, it's down to one run. Top fuel eliminator in the near lane from Seattle, Washington, Jerry Ruth. He had his problems in the semifinal round, a bit of controversy arising over the decision there, but we have a race in the final, and it's Jerry Ruth against Shirley Muldowney, the winner of the Spring Nationals. Jerry Ruth, a former world champion, in the finals against Shirley Muldowney. Shirley has to be considered the favorite. She has low elapsed time and top speed. Let's watch. And something goes wrong with Jerry Ruth's car as Shirley Muldowney streaks to the win. 594, 248 miles an hour. Let's watch in slow motion. It's a close race at this point. Jerry Ruth maybe with a wheel lead, and Shirley Muldowney takes the win. Frank?
You were shooting for 250. You didn't get to 250, but you did win. How do you feel?
Well, warm right now. No, I feel pretty good. Jerry thinks that he had me beat, but I was driving around him. He lost the belt, but I was driving around him.
It got controversial even before you got into the finals, and now that it's hindsight, go through it a little bit with me.
Well, according to the rules, National High Rod Association, that once a driver gets one chance and one chance only, and when he or she does not fire, they don't wait a half hour and give him or her another chance. And Steve Gibbs, the tech director, felt that it was fair. It was his decision. He's the man that makes them. And he wanted to make a drag race out of it. And really, with all the people here, I can't really blame him.
It's easy to be a Monday morning quarterback, but it was so beautiful in Columbus. Your feelings now, the season is over and you ended it the way you did.
Yeah, I'm plenty happy. I got a good crew. They're great. They're just great. Hi, son.
One very happy lady, Shirley Muldowney, winner of Top Fuel Eliminator at the 76 World Final.
Don the Snake Prudhomme has asked, what made Shirley Muldowney such a great drag racer?
Well, my honest feeling about Shirley is that it was part of the time in drag racing where we were all fighting for survival. We ran match races, we had to win races, we didn't really have any sponsors to speak of, and it was so important to win and win and make enough dough to go to the next track. Well, she was the same way. She just happens to be a woman, but she was tough as nails. You know, I wish today she was still out here and had a team or something, but she was tough, but I think she had to be tough to survive.
The following year in 1977, Shirley Muldowney won her first of three NHRA Top Fuel Championships. In 1976, Don the Snake Prudhomme won his second of four consecutive Funny Car crowns. And after his 1976 World Finals Pro Stock victory and the only all-AMC Pro Stock final in NHRA history, Wally Booth continued to compete until retiring at the end of the 1979 season. His 1976 World Finals teammate and runner-up in that race, Dave Canners, sadly passed away from cancer in the spring of 2009. We'll be back with a quick look at our next show right after this.
Coming up next week, Shirley Muldowney invades the home turf of arch rival Big Daddy Don Garland's at the 1982 Gator Nationals in Gainesville, Florida. In Funny Car, an unknown driver from north of the border is about to make his presence felt, while Bob Glidden's Ford-powered Pro Stock Dominance is being put to the test by a Chevy-powered upstart from the state of Texas. All coming up next time.
For the NHRA's greatest races presented by ProCare RX, I'm Bill Stevens.